Hi everyone, welcome to Heaven, Healing, and Tarot. This is Christina, and today's pick a card is channeled messages from your future spouse. So we'll see what your person's higher self wants you to know. Before I get started, I always send out some healing. Take a deep breath with me. All right, pile one. A grateful heart is a magnet for miracles. Aw, I like that. Pile two. You would think I would have read it before I put them out, right? Pile two is do more. Do what makes you happy. Sorry, do more of what makes you happy. Pile three. Be the game changer. Love that one. Be the game changer. All right, so take a moment, pick the pile you are most drawn to, and we'll see what your future spouse wants you to know. Hi, pile one. If you chose Grateful Heart, then this one is your reading. Let's pull some tarot. Seven of Swords, the Magician, Nine of Pentacles, Queen of Cups, Knight of Cups. All right. I've been manifesting you for a while. I can't wait for you to be in my life. I can't wait for you to get here. I want you so badly. I can't wait to begin a life with you. I have so much love to give you. I have so much just to share with you. I can't wait to find the romance, the excitement. I just love who you are. I love your personality. I love how confident you can be at things. I love how you appreciate things. I love how capable you are. You are so loving and supportive when people need you. You're such a good listener and a good friend to those people. You have a lot of empathy, which sometimes is a little bit of a hindrance for you, but that just shows how big your heart is. I know sometimes you get a little shy and a little insecure, but you're so creative and you have these abilities that just amaze me. You can be so charismatic and so charming, and yet you could be a little shy. It's kind of like mysterious and sexy. I can't wait to be with you. Ooh, okay. Wow, they just pulled out of me like all at once, like they went like they got sucked out. Well, they're in a fun mood today. All good things, right? They had some really nice things to say about you, and it looks like they're going to be so romantic towards you. They're going to be so in love with you, and I feel like they've been praying for someone like you for a while. You know, maybe they've got to change some strategy in order to attract you in, but yeah, this is exciting. Very exciting. Let's get a few more cards for you. Here's your marriage card. Here's your 1111 card. So this is definitely a future spouse. This is somebody you're going to have build a firm foundation with, somebody you're going to celebrate life with, and to just be a happy family. Nice. Three Pentacles. They're like still leaving. I'm like, my body's getting jerked. Three of Pentacles, somebody who wants to be your teammate, somebody who wants to work with you to grow and to build and to expand and co-create. Someone who sees you as, you know, a true partner, somebody they could count on. gotta love that. I love the way your person feels about you. Music for manifesting. So they listen to songs that get them in some kind of a mood to manifest you, or to think about, you know, maybe different lyrics of songs make them think about their ideal person. Or if they know you, they think it makes them think about you. But they definitely use music. This person can be a musician, can be somebody who creates music. Like you'll be their muse, like you inspire them, or the thoughts of you inspire them. But for the most part, I feel like lyrics really hit home with them. Like they resonate with lyrics in songs. Okay, that is what it is. All right. Do all things in moderation. Oh, so this person probably is learning to do things in moderation. I kind of feel like your person is someone who goes overboard. Like, yeah. Like they could be a spender, but I feel like if they're a spender, they make the money, they make enough money to be a spender. If they, like, there's somebody who goes all in is what I feel like. They don't do things in moderation, but they're learning to. They're not learning not to be so overpowering. So like if they drink, I feel like when they drink to get drunk. They might not drink all the time, but when they do, they're having four or five. They're not having one or two. So they're learning that they've got to scale back. I think this is part of a lesson, and maybe this is something that you'll help them with. Or if this is someone you knew and they were somebody who did things in excess, now in life, they're not. They do things in moderation. For some reason, I'm feeling like it's a health thing. Like they do things in moderation. They've learned to do things in moderation now for their health. I don't know. That's what I'm getting. So whatever. Maybe that's just a way for you to recognize who this is. New opportunities, declutter your life. So I think this is saying if you declutter your life, this person will have an opportunity to come in. So however that resonates for you, whatever you got to declutter, whether it's your mind and negative thoughts, or whether it's your actual space to make energy flow to you, or getting rid of like relationships that are no longer serving you, or whatever this is, whatever you have to declutter, declutter. Indecisive. Is this you, or is this your person who has a hard time making decisions? Somebody has a hard time making decisions. I don't know. I'm not getting much from it. All must have prizes, trying to please everyone. I do feel like your person, that's why they do things in excess. They are trying to please everyone. They want everyone to be happy. They want to be the good guy. They want everybody to like them. So they do things in excess sometimes. That's why they're learning to do things in moderation. So this person, when they show you love, they're going to shower you with love. Where you're like, you don't have to do all that. Like, they're not going to just buy you one rose. They're going to buy you dozens of roses. They're not going to, you know, they're going to do things in excess. But I feel like it's not a detriment to their pocketbook. I feel like they can afford to do what they do. But Yeah, it's because they want to make you happy. They want to make sure you're happy. Maybe that's why they're indecisive sometimes, or how they show they're indecisive, because maybe they're like, don't know, I lost my train of thought on that one. Don't know where they showed me something, and I by explaining it wrong, I lost it. Can you give me that back, please? I don't know. Maybe that's why they go in excess, because they're afraid that they're not going to make you happy. So instead of picking and choosing one item, they just buy them all or something like that. That's where the indecisiveness comes in, maybe. That's, I think, where I was going with it. Like, they have a hard time just choosing because they don't want to disappoint you. They don't want to make the wrong choice. So it's, if you ask them to bring you home fruit instead of just bringing you apples or bananas, they brought you apples, bananas, grapes, strawberries, blueberries. They brought you them all because they couldn't make up their mind. But you asked for fruit, I brought you fruit. Something like that, you know? What's the one thing you're grateful for? Because you're blessed. So your person's blessed, and I think you're going to be blessed to have this person in your life. I really do. I think this is a good one for you. This is a good person you're going to marry. They're going to take care of you. They're going to love you. Detach from drama. Look up. Oh, does this person stir the pot or get involved in drama? My dad was like that. My dad was like, I didn't do nothing, but the whole time he's the one who's like behind the scenes stirring the pot. That's what, and I'm saying that because I kind of feel like this person does that. And it's not in a malicious way, it's just that they can't help themselves. They're getting involved in drama. So, I don't know. Let me see what this says. Detach from drama. Let's read. All right. Whatever you are going through, whatever is weakening, challenging, or hurting you is something that can be eased by changing a mindset or stance. Nothing is made better by thinking negatively. All right, so this is why you have to declutter, or somebody has to declutter. It is easy to get sucked into drama, and this can be of your own making or it can be created by others. It doesn't matter where it originates from, the effect is the same. And that's to take away you from your personal power and light. So maybe you grew up around people who argue or always expect the worst or only see the negative in a situation. Maybe they thrive in chaos and disharmony. And that's what you learned. You learned it from. You just have to pull back from that. All right. If you are the one who is addicted to drama, all you have to do is breathe deeply, look up to the sunlight rather than down to the ground, and open up to a new way forward. Detach now from anything that drains you and anything that drains you energetically, and any person who lowers you, or any situation that keeps you small. All right, we're going to declutter those people from our life. This card also highlights the need to detach from drama in the world by those stuck in third dimensional energy. So don't let what's going on in the world affect you either in a negative light. Just hold light, stay positive. Like, you don't have to get sucked into the world's drama either. So this is saying, learn to stop thinking negatively and to be more positive. It's saying that, things have to change a little bit. So is that you or is that your person? Kind of feel like it's your person. Kind of feel like it's your person. But anyway, it's not a bad thing. We all get sucked into drama at times, and we all have to learn how to declutter that and to release it. So, Again, just a way to recognize who this person is, but for the most part, you guys are going to be really happy. This person is somebody who wants to be a pleaser and who's super romantic. Such a sweetheart, really, a sweet person. But they'll learn and grow, just like we all do. We all have lessons to learn, so they'll be fine. This is a person that's going to improve with age, or has improved with age. Okay, so I like that. I like that because it shows growth, right? All right, let's pull some initials. Let's get some initials on this one. Who do we got coming out here? What do we got? We have A, B, I, J, M, P, R, T, W, X, and Y. Well, I'm just gonna put it there. All right. So that's what I have for you. Give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment. All those things help me, and I appreciate you for it. Till next time, love and light. Hi, pile two. If you chose, I think I just called it happy, then this one's going to be your pile. Let me get you some cards. Page of Wands. Five of Swords. King of Wands. King of Pentacles. Six of Swords. All right, let's see. I just love your personality. You're someone who wants to do everything, who knows that they can do everything if they wanted to, if they put their mind to it. Someone who is excited about life and exciting about doing new things, taking some risks, and putting yourself out there. I know sometimes you get to feeling restless, and you need to shake things up in your life every now and then. Don't worry, I will comply with that. Whenever you get too restless, I'll find something exciting for us to look forward to. Maybe it'll be a weekend away or finding a new hobby for us to do together. Don't worry, I'll make life interesting for you. We're going to butt heads a little bit every now and then. Our personalities are a lot alike, and so we're going to want to both be right or in charge at times. But don't you worry. Don't you worry. We won't get stuck in that cycle of conflict. We will learn each other. We'll learn to compromise, and we'll learn not to push someone to their breaking point, right? Because we both have this fire energy within us. King of Wands. King of Wands. I think that just pulled me out of it. Hang on, let me get back. Of Wands. Why did they say King of Wands? I mean, I know it's there, but when we meet, you're gonna be entering this new phase of emotional maturity. where you will respect your independence as well as mine. You'll respect the fact that we have individual goals. You won't constantly be needing that attention that you did when you were younger, that always needing that reaffirming energy. You are at a point in your life when we come together that you have learned to just have a little more faith and to just be you and enjoy your freedom a little bit more. I don't think that I think you've gotten to a point where you weren't in a rush to settle down. You knew you still had growing to do. And I'm going to be there when you're ready. We're going to be financially stable because I, and as well as yourself, are very reliable. But I'm going to be very generous with you, and I just kind of know how to make money. It's always going to come to me. And it's going to come to me because of things that I've done. I've worked hard for that status in my life. But it will allow us to have this stability together. Because you're just as competent as I am, as far as making money and having abundance. Money always comes to you. You have this way of attracting it to you or coming up with ideas on how to increase that. So I'm not worried about any kind of financial difficulties. I find you very inquisitive. I find you strategically minded, like me. We're a lot alike. I don't know why I keep getting pulled out of this, but they pulled me out again. So I'm going to leave it there. So basically what I've gotten is that you guys are a lot alike. You might have a lot of ambition, the two of you. And I don't know. I think you're going to have an exciting, prosperous life together. There's going to be a lot of abundance, a lot of excitement and happiness. I feel like your person's super attracted to you. And things always work out for them. So, like, when you bring them an idea, they'll either be like, okay, we can run with that, or maybe we shouldn't do that, because your person is good with money. So they're going to, like, be the, they're just going to know what's a good deal and what's not a good deal. I don't want to say that they're frugal or cheap in any way, because they're not. They're not. They're going to give you the world. You're going to have whatever you want. You're going to be able to spend your money on whatever you want. They're not going to limit you, because they're the type of person that knows that money's going to just keep coming in. And you are going to contribute that. You make your own money. So I think together you guys are really going to be a force to be reckoned with. But I do feel a little bit that you will bump heads a little bit, because I feel like you're both very strong, independent people. And, you both might want your way all the time. So you'll have to learn to compromise a little bit. But that's every relationship, you have to learn to compromise. So that's nothing that you can't do. Victory and success. You will be successful. Trust your intuition on this one. This one is telling you, I also feel like with that the divine is bringing you guys together. I think that they're helping you here. They're helping you have a secure relationship. Tranquility. Make time to relax, be still, and enjoy your solitude. See, I kind of feel like you're both go-getters. Like, you're both hustlers. You both work hard. You both are high energy. So there are going to be times where you need to just slow it down. And when you feel like you need to slow it down, slow it down. All right, that's your body telling you, we need a break. I kind of think you're both like that, so you need to respect your person when they feel like that too. You know, and they need to respect you when you feel like that. Forgive and forget. This is what you guys are going to do. And you guys will forget. You guys are going to, when you guys bump heads, because you will, you're going to be just as quick to forgive and move on from it. And you guys are going to forget about it. You're not even, like, in a year, you're not even going to remember that you fought over something stupid. Or, and we might not feel like it was stupid at the time. But you're not even going to remember it. You are going to forgive and forget. You guys, I feel like, run hot, but you burn out just as fast. And not with each other, but with arguments in that situation where you might feel strongly about something, but once it's done, once it's out, once you said your piece, once you feel heard and vice versa, you guys move on. Like, you don't hold grudges. You just move on. You let go. Which is actually kind of better. I mean, it's not good to get so hot, but it's better to forgive and forget than it is to have to remember all the negative and hold on to that negative. So I kind of like it for you guys. Pure intention. Find clarity. Surrender your ego. Pure intention. Your person is, and you are both in it for the right reasons, and you guys will love each other and have pure intentions towards each other. Like, you're not going to try to hurt each other on purpose or anything like that. You guys are going to be pure of heart. It tells me that you're soul connected. Strategy. Somebody's really smart. Somebody's super smart in this. And I kind of feel like it's your King of Pentacles. I kind of feel like they are... just like I said, they're good with money. They know how to make money, and they might tell you what's a good deal and what's not a good deal. I think they're smart. I really do. Shine bright like a candle. You will make it through this. So when you guys have these disagreements, please just remember it's a temporary thing. You'll get through it. Don't get sad over it. Okay? Cultivate inner Buddha. Again, you need that calm. Sometimes you guys are going to need to recharge at times. Have a beautiful day. So just remember to do so when you're feeling like you need it. Give each other that space when you guys need to recharge, when you guys need to take it easy. Don't always go, 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 go. And if you need to ask for help to be able to recharge, do so. Mother Earth, grounding and support. It's number, what is it, 18? Let's see. 18. Your attention is drawn to the need to ground your energies into the earth. If you struggle with bringing your dreams and ideas to reality, remember that everything is built one block at a time. All it takes is for the first block to be placed, which sets your intention and says to the wider universe that you are serious and this is real. The seed only grows into a tree because it was planted, so plant something new today. So again, this is saying that you don't always have to be on full speed. You could build something one block at a time. That's the most stable and sturdy of foundations, is when you do it one step at a time. So don't rush anything here. I feel like you guys are both high energy, so just remember, just slow it down when you need to, and it's okay to be fast energy, but make sure you're doing things in the right way. But I think that you guys are kind of a perfect match for each other. So let me pull some charms. Debt charms, initials. Now I'm yawning. I'm sorry I got pulled out. I was a little strange. I kept getting pulled out. I don't know. Anyway. A, B, C, D, G, I, J, T, W, and Z. Oh, there's an H. Oh, there's an E. Alright, pile two. That is what I have for you. Give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment. All those things help me, and I appreciate you for it. Till next time, love and light. Hi, pile three. If you chose Game Changer, then this one's going to be your reading. Let's get some cards for you. Page of Cups. Page of Pentacles, Queen of Swords, Eight of Swords, Six of Cups. You have such a gentle, loving, warm personality. I really like to be around you. You make me feel special. I know that you can be shy and you tend to avoid the spotlight at times. I know, but I know you're strong and I know your confidence and I know you won't back down from a fight if there's a need for you to. But you're pretty down to earth, and you're responsible and hardworking, and I really see that we have great potential here to last a very long time. You tend to fully commit, and I am going to see that and appreciate that, that you go all in. You're intuitive, and you're wise, and you're smart. You're pretty logical. Sometimes I'm going to like think that you think you know best when I think I know best. But for the most part, you're pretty smart. You don't always feel desirable though. And your walls are up. You protect yourself from rejection. You've been hurt. You have this insecurity that stems from childhood. But I'm going to make you feel loved. I'm going to make you feel like you need to let all that go and to heal all that. Because you're pretty amazing. And I know I can count on you. Well, that's it. That's all they got. That's what they stopped. I don't know why they stopped there, but they stopped there. So, what do we got here? Let's look. They could be younger than you. Look at these pages. They could be somebody who's younger than you, but they're smart. They have clarity. They know what they want. They do get a lot of anxiety, though, about things. But this is somebody who's going to make you feel good. This is somebody who's going to make you feel happy and young and free, and somebody who's really going to put a smile on your face. So that's absolutely beautiful. Let's see what else they're going to do here. What else we got? Fool, new beginnings, and the Hermit. card. Sorry, God, for some reason, couldn't get that out. The Virgo card. A new beginning. Could this be somebody from your past? Somebody that you used to know? Maybe not necessarily somebody you dated, but somebody you used to know? Could this be somebody coming back? It's possible. But if not, they're just telling you, just lower your walls. Take a leap of faith. This person has good intentions. Right? You don't have to be so protective. You can be a little vulnerable here and let them in. Yeah. All right, let's see what else comes out here. Helpful person. Someone who wants to help. So this is somebody who always is there for you. Somebody who's always going to lend a helping hand. Somebody who's always going to be there for you. Somebody you can count on. Love that. Love that. They're going to want to make your life easier. Built on solid ground. Yeah, so that's beautiful. You're going to build a very stable, sturdy relationship. This is not somebody who wants to play games. This is somebody who's in it for the long haul, and they want a serious commitment. And they see how amazing you are, and they're going to prove that to you, that you know, that's how they think. They think you're amazing. They're going to show you. You're going to feel it. Open your heart, love yourself, and dare to be vulnerable. So there you go. Let your walls down for this one, or you're going to let your walls down. This person's not going to give you a choice. You're going to be head over heels for this one. This one's going to sweep you off your feet and hit you in a way that no one's ever hit you before. And you're going to have to be vulnerable. You're going to have to take a risk here. You're going to have to take a leap of faith. But this person's going to make you really, really, really happy. You got the sun. I mean, that's just warmth and happiness and joy and bliss and all the good stuff. So this is going to be an amazing marriage. Yeah, I love it. I love this for you. We're all mad here. Everyone is a little different. So this could be this person could be different than your normal type, or they could see your uniqueness and appreciate it and value it. And they're saying it's okay to be different. We're all mad. We're all crazy. We're all, you know, unique in our own way, which is absolutely true. But your person sees the value in it. You gotta kind of love that. That's a very special person there. Don't let this one go. This one seems absolutely perfect. Chakras loaded and ready. Zen. Finding Zen. I can't say what it says. Chakras loaded and ready. So this is the... Oh, okay. So what they're saying is this person's gonna be aligned with you. You guys are going to be in perfect harmony, perfect balance. This is your person. I mean, we know it's your future spouse, but that doesn't mean anything, right? Sometimes we marry the wrong people. But this is saying, no, this is the right person for you, that you guys are totally in alignment with each other and meant to be. Oh, yellow, joy, happiness. You're your sun again. That's beautiful energy. You guys are going to be so happy. I'm so happy for you. You guys are really going to get each other, and you're going to love each other, and you're going to understand each other, and it's just going to work. It's just going to work. I couldn't be happier for you. This is a beautiful person for you. This is absolutely amazing. Wow. All right, let me put you some initials. Let's see. All right, what do we got? D. G. I. K. M. N. O. P X. Not very many, but that's what came out. What do you think? don't know. Anyway, this was a very quick read. Wasn't long at all. Give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment. All those things help me, and I appreciate you for it. Till next time, love and light.